So in order to calculate V of 16, it will be equal to 16 minus 15, T minus T1, divided by T minus T2, divided by T naught, which is 10, minus T1, times T naught minus T2, that's 10 minus 20. Multiplied by the velocity at T naught, which is 227.04. So the second part is, again, T minus T naught, which is 16 minus 10, times T minus T2, which is 16 minus 20, divided by 15 minus 10, which is T1 minus T naught, and then you have T1 minus T2, which is 15 minus 20, times the velocity at T sub 1, which is 362.78. And then we have the third part, which is T minus T naught, which is again 16 minus 10, times 16 minus 20, which is T minus T sub 2, divided by T2 minus T naught, which is 15 minus 10, and then T2 minus T1, which is 15 minus 20, times the velocity at T sub 2, which is 362.78. Sorry, if it's 16 minus 15, so this is not right. Let me just rewrite this third part. It'll be 16 minus 10, T minus T naught, times T minus T sub 1, which is 16 minus 15, divided by T2 minus T naught, which is 20 minus 10, T2 minus T1, which is 20 minus 15, times V sub of T2, which is 517.35. So those are the Lagrangian weights which you are getting for the three different velocities which you have. So what I'm going to do is, rather than calculate the whole number for you, I'm going to show you what the what each of these get weighted by. You have minus 0.08 times 227.04. This is the weight which is given to the velocity at T sub naught, plus 0.96 times 362.78. So that's the amount of weightage which is giving to the velocity at T sub 1, plus 0.12 times the velocity at T sub 2, which is 517.35. So you may well see that the amount of weightage which is given to each of these velocities at T sub naught, T sub 1, T sub 2, is minus 0.08 here, 0.96, and 0.12 here. If you add all these weights, it will turn out to be 1, of course. So that's the way you should interpret a Lagrangian interpolation. So if you do this, we get 392.19 meter per second. So that's what turns out to be the velocity at 16. And that's the end of this segment.